fate has smiled on these teams once. Which team will catch your eye again in this second-round matchup between the Cal State Fullerton Titans and the USC Trojans?
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Trojans are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Yeah, on a night like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, don't let their big man become a factor offensively. Keep him off the block, push him away from the low box, and force him to shoot jump shots. Secondly, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense. And lastly, be monsters on the boards. Don't be afraid to get tangled up. Crash the glass.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby. Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They're working around the perimeter. Albert receives the ball. He makes a nice shot fake.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of box.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Trying to feed inside. Goes up for two.
I love the guy hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
Thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale. And has it rejected.
Defense to the break. The blocked shot.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again.
Up and inside.
Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Leans in. Basket falls despite the contact. Gave it up. He went for the steal in the post and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
They look to get it to the inside. Using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop. Takes the ball to the goal. Strong.
They push it up on the break. For two, USC are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I got defense reacting and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
The Trojans will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. And now there's a whistle and a foul. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Grabs the board.
And they've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
For the bucket, perfectly executed. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I think the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator. Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
They've got a three-point shooter spotting up.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Number 54 handles the pass. Way off target. On the dribble, gives it up. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He strokes it. He gets the bucket.
How about an instant replay?
Wynn is animated and ready to go.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Number 22 makes the shot.
Double team now, bad angle.
Steele, go up the other way, get a layup.
Looking for contact. He puts it in with contact and all. Shot clock is dead. Dumps it in. Trying to draw some contact. The layup.
The ball loose.
Puts it up looking for contact. And he scores despite the half. At the half, the Trojans are ahead by two. Thus far, it's been a tightly contested game. Dick, what's your highlight of the first half?
Check out some of the inside play we witnessed in the first half. We saw some great baskets down low, which really opened up the outside range for both teams.
Well, Dick, let's see what's in store for us here in the second half. USC showed dominance on the boards, Dick, in the first half.
Yeah, and therefore they control the game. Rebound and wins games, my friend.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us here.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Erin. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post-play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Dickie's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. He pump fakes. Unloads a three. He buries the shot. Number two handles the feed. Gave it up. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He takes the board. He fires from long range. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
It's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post-defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
They work the perimeter. The power forward with the ball. He's got a nice shot fake. attempts the old-fashioned hook shot. USC are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, that'll keep pushing if they can't force a timeout.
The power forward gets the pass. Looking for a good shot. Unloads. Rims out. Latagola receives the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops, and do it now.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet J.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I'll tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offense.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
Shoots from the top of the key. He can't get the bucket to fall. Takes away the pass. The power forward handles the feed. Foul charge. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
He has a chance to cash him in. First one, good. Gets the second. Wow, the defender got the worst of that hard screen. That's a matter of clock management, isn't it, Dick? Dick, we're going to look here at the front court players and how they're performing.
Who can dominate the paint is the question, Mr. Nestler. Sometimes the bigs get lost with all of the guard play, but to win consistently, you need to have a balanced attack inside and outside.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Nobody likes this point of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. And look at that stat.
I tell you one thing, coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose hair and you get balled like I am.
And the clock stopped with a foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. And yet another foul. Latagona steps to the line for the first time. Misses the front end of the one and one. The point guard with the ball. Working around the perimeter. He shoots from left of the circle. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
On the outside. On the dribble, gives it up. Working it around the perimeter. Moving it around the perimeter. Hard foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He goes to the line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Makes the shot. Shot clock is dead. He tries the three. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Kicks it out. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Gave it up. Cross court. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, and you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Trojans is on their way to the Sweet 16 now after dispatching both their first two foes.
I'll tell you, Brad, these young men are bringing their A game, and their third-round opponents better be prepared because these kids are looking to go all the way, baby.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.